Dental Sports Central, we give our next team prediction of this offseason. And Issy River, potentially one of the biggest dark horses in the nation going into the 2021 season, and that's going to be the Miami Hurricanes. This team was 8-3 overall in the 2020 season. Overall, I'd say this team was very underrated in 2020. I mean, you heard a lot about Clemson and you heard a lot about North Carolina, but you didn't hear much about Miami, which is definitely surprising to me considering, I mean, this team's got Derek King and they're definitely on the rise going into the 2021 season. Why that is what we're going over here today. We're going to go in and get started with Miami's final prediction. We'll be starting out with your season trends here today, looking back at 2020 for the Hurricanes. And of course, once again, this team had an 8-3 overall record last year. 4-1 in their first five games, 4-2 in their last six. So this team was very consistent over the course of 2020. Beat Louisville there 47-34. Also had a huge blowout win over Florida State 52-10. They didn't even have a chance in that game. NC State, of course, they beat them on the road 44-41. Big win there. Also beat Virginia Tech on the road 25-24. So once again, Miami last season, I definitely say, was one of the more underrated teams for sure. I mean, of course, Derek King transferring in, that made a huge difference for this Miami team. I mean, he came in from Houston, and in Houston, I mean, he was a great quarterback, and then he comes in to Miami, which is, or it turned out to be huge for this team. And I think Derek King definitely could lead Miami to a very good season in 2021. This could be the best season that Miami has had in a long time, I think, coming up here in 2021. Only problem is for Miami is this team's got to go up against North Carolina. And I think for Miami and North Carolina, I mean, both of those teams are going to be dueling it out quite a bit in this 2021 season, because I mean, the winner of that that matchup there between Miami and North Carolina could easily depend or easily determine who wins the division, which of course, I mean, I could easily see Miami or whichever team who wins the division taking down Clemson in the other division. So I definitely think Miami's got a big chance to have a great season coming up here in 2021. Looking at your returning production though, this just explains why I think this team could be so good next year. You got Derek King coming back, Cameron Harris also coming back, so you got your top running back there and your starting quarterback both coming back for next season. Looking at Derek King here, put up 2,600 yards, 23 touchdowns, 5 interceptions, also a 64% completion rate last season. So he definitely, once again, put up some pretty outstanding stats in 2020, and that could easily move forward into 2021 for sure. He's still on the rise. I mean, if he could put up a 67 or a 68% completion rate, like, this Miami team could be outstanding next season. This offense could be one of the best in the nation. Cameron Harris, of course, once again, your top running back there, put up just over 770 yards last year, 11 touchdowns as well. Donald Chaney was your second running back last year. He's also coming back. He put up 460 yards as well last year, so both your running backs are coming back for 2021. As for the receiving core here, you got Mike Harley, who's coming back. That's going to be huge for Derek King in this offense. He's definitely got the most experience, I'd say, in the receiving core here, as he put up 812 yards and 7 touchdowns last season. As for Brevin Jordan, he was your tight end. Definitely one of the more underrated tight ends in the nation, I'd say. Of course, he is, or he was also your second in receiving yards last season, put up 507 yards of offense for Miami. As for your third, or your second wide receiver there with Mark Pope, he will be back for next season, put up just over 400 yards. So overall, the receiving core looks great. I mean, you already got Mike Harley and Mark Pope both coming back. But of course, you got Charleston Rambo. Don't forget about him. He's coming in from Oklahoma, transferring in. He was a very big impact player for the Oklahoma Sooners back a couple seasons ago. And of course, if you look at 2020, put up just over 330 yards for the Sooners, 3 touchdowns. Back in 2019, though, is really when we saw him play very well. 750 yards is what he had in 2019, 5 touchdowns as well. So he is definitely a player to watch out for heading into the 2021 season for Miami. He could actually be a huge impact player that Miami didn't even know that they needed. But I mean, when he comes in there, I mean, for Miami and for Derek King, that could be a huge addition for this offense, and I definitely think it will be. As for the defensive side, you lose 3 defensive linemen. That's the main position that I'm kind of concerned about for Miami, is the defensive line, whether or not this team can handle losing 3 there. But I think this team has got enough depth, and the recruiting's been pretty good for Miami as well. So I'd say overall, they should be just fine defensively, but they also lose one of the secondary there. Don't forget about that. But Derek King returning for one more season. This is going to be a major season for Miami, I think, coming up here. I mean, this is just about as good of a chance as Miami has of being a national contender. Or this is the best chance that they've had in a long time, I'd at least say. I mean, Miami's definitely got potential to beat out Clemson this upcoming season, and that's what you're going to see, especially if this team plays as well as they easily could. I mean, if you see Miami in the ACC championship game against Clemson, that's easily going to be a close game. Like, usually we've seen Clemson just control the ACC and win it outright. Not this season. It's going to be very close up top, especially with Clemson, Miami, North Carolina. And I think this could easily be the one season, this could be the first season in a while that we actually see a team other than Clemson win the ACC, and Miami's definitely a front runner to do so. Chance of winning the division. Once again, this is a big question and a huge factor in determining how Miami's season is going to go. I mean, if they don't win the division, I mean, the chances of you having an outstanding season are, I mean, you're already going to have a great season, but if you don't win the division, your chances of being in the college football playoff obviously are over. So, I mean, you've got to win the division first, and then once you get to the ACC championship game, that's where you really have got to have a huge game and beat Clemson. And potentially, I mean, if they beat Clemson, that basically means that they're in for the college football playoff, of course. So, yeah, for Miami, this is a team that I definitely think has got potential. I mean, with Derek King once again, this could be Miami season for sure. Looking at your schedule, though, for next season, this is a terrible schedule set up for 2021. It's just so unfortunate for this team that they've got to play Alabama in their first week. I mean, especially when you've got such a crucial role in having to win the division. I mean, you've got to win the division this season, and having a game against Alabama at the top is not going to help you. I mean, if there was any season where you did not want to play Alabama, this would be the one, because, I mean, that's just a brutal opponent on your schedule. And I think, don't get me wrong, I think Alabama's definitely, I mean, they'll be good next season, but I think Miami's definitely got a chance to stick around in that matchup. That could definitely be a close game there. It's just a matter of which team comes ready to play more. But, I mean, Miami does have more experience than Alabama. The Alabama team lost quite a bit this offseason, so who knows? We could see a potential major upset in that matchup. I mean, I'm not counting Miami out by any means in that matchup. Then you got Appalachian State, you got Michigan State after that as well, so your non-conference games are pretty tough. You also got CCSU after that. Virginia, you've got them on September 30th. North Carolina, that's your major game once again on October 16th. Whichever team wins that game on October 16th could easily, or should easily, win the division next season. That's going to be a huge game for both those teams there. NC State, you got them after that. Pittsburgh on the road. You got Georgia Tech, Florida State to finish off, or to start your November. And then you got Virginia Tech and Duke to finish off your regular season. So looking at your September here, you got five games. Alabama, that's going to be a close one. I mean, as much as I want to see Miami win that game, like, don't get me wrong, I would love to see Miami win against Alabama. I just don't see it happening. I think Alabama next season, they're going to come ready to go, and I think Nick Saban is going to make sure that this team knows that Miami is for real next season. And it's going to be close, but I'm going to give Miami the win in the end. I just think Miami is too good of a – or I'm going to give Alabama the win in the end. I just think they're just too good of a team right now to go against. So, but looking at Appalachian State, that'll be a win. Michigan State will be a win. CCSU, also an easy win. Virginia, also on the easy win list. So you got four easy wins after that. That's definitely going to build this team's confidence going into a brutal October month and a very crucial game against North Carolina there. So you'll be 4-1 heading into that North Carolina matchup. Not a bad record at all. I mean, if you got two losses heading into the North Carolina matchup, it's almost a must win if you want any chance of winning the division next season. Which, looking at October, I'm going to give you the win against North Carolina. I think it's going to be mighty close. I mean, with it being in North Carolina, that could be a tough, tough matchup. And I've gone back and forth already so many times on that. It's going to be a fun matchup once we get to there in mid-October. But I'm going to give it to Miami. I think Miami just is the better team looking at the two teams. And I think also Miami is the more experienced team. Like, if you look at North Carolina's returning production, they look very good returning production-wise. But Miami is more experienced than North Carolina. So, I mean, once again, it could easily go either way. I mean, it's basically a 50-50 game if you ask me. I'm going to give Miami the win. I think Miami right now is just looking like the better team to me, and I think after playing a tough Alabama team, they'll give them enough experience to really give it to North Carolina in that matchup. NC State, you got them after that. They'll be a close one, but I'm going to give it to Miami, especially after coming off of that huge game against North Carolina. That could be a close matchup, but once again, I'll give it to Miami. Pittsburgh, you got them after that. That's going to be an easy win, I do say. So you're going to be 7-1 heading into your November. As for November, I mean, you got four somewhat easier matchups, definitely winnable matchups. I mean, if you win all four, you're more than likely going to be in the ACC championship game. So, I mean, no pressure there. But yeah, looking at November, you got Georgia Tech. That's an easy win. Florida State's going to be a close one. I like Florida State next season, actually, a decent amount. I think they could be a decent team. Definitely a bowl team next year with Mackenzie Milton. But that'll be a win for Miami. As for Virginia Tech, that'll be an easy win. Duke will be an easy win. You're going to finish out the season with an 11-1 record. and you're going to be on your way to the ACC Championship game. I do have you going right now to the ACC Championship game over North Carolina. Once again, though, it's a very dangerous season. I mean, even one loss, even one bad game is going to cause you to miss the ACC Championship game, thus also missing a New Year's Six bowl bid. So, I mean, for Miami, I mean, this is a team that I definitely think has got potential next season, but you just, once again, I mean, with Alabama on the schedule, that makes it so much more of a tougher season, especially trying to win the division there. But yeah, once again, 11-1 is a record for next season. That is what I'm predicting right now. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, though, on Miami. I do appreciate you guys all watching. If you enjoyed the preview, slap a like on it, subscribe as well, as it does help out the channel. I'd really appreciate that. But once again, yeah, thanks again for watching. Stay tuned for more from All Sports Central. I'll see you guys later.